game number three. This
It's
time to end this simulation, right. I think.
It's not fun to have to run all the way out there. Now Snake King in some trouble. Misha can get the right clicks out with those glaives to get this kill. They've also got DM coming over. He'll take Timber Chain for that level two and has the Whirling Death to get himself that first kill. And Misha gets plus two early on.
This is a Keeper of the Light. Boots of Travel already finished 6 minutes into the game.
Avalanche and toss onto an Illusion. Arcane Curse and the Telekinesis on a Soxa. Knight pulls his down, Soxa looking like he's going to lose his life, but just gets the Fairy Fire off and walks behind the tower. Now Nine's come over, Yoragi needs to run away, but the Blinding Light, the Illuminate, and the kill for Nine off that rotation. Soxa will eventually fall to the Fade Bolt coming through from Taiga, but that is not a trade you want to be making.
If they get
and you
Taiga
lost
as
Misha
well,
too.
Another Blinding Light is available in 2 seconds, but the low on mana on Keeper of the Light. Malefice, going to smoke. They want to get a big kill, and it seems like Skeeter is the one that they're looking for.
They still breathe fire, but Snake King and Nine are here. So Icarus Dive, it's both heroes.
Phoenix
they took
only
the
level
sun
five,
on a Snake
though.
King. Now they've got the Sun Ray. DM starting to burn real heavily. That metal's going to get real hot. Taiga, he ends up dead, but BZM coming over from the side, trying to get a kill here out of the Coddle. They should be able to take him out, but they'll lose DM for it. Now Misha up a bit far. We've got 33, and he's got Malefice. That means Misha, they've got locked down to Chase. They still want BZM. They'll throw the Avalanche. They won't land it. And eventually, Misha will die because Skitters breathe fire. They get themselves nine, but losing three for that is just too many numbers.
And they immediately smoke. There is toss available on Soxa.
They're not too far behind, so later timing isn't exactly terrible for them. We've seen teams just get too far behind when they're looking for that late game. Now, DM, Avalanche, toss, Spirit Vessel on him. He'll pop the mech, the black hole comes in from 33, and that will finish off the Timber Saw. Damage 9, because he's sitting there with half health when he originally was over.
Oh, they saw the courier.
Yeah, they're following the courier. Now Yoragi's forced to saw. TP out, and Illuminate won't hit, but top lane, BZM, he's still in trouble and will fall. The song from the TP, not going to reach in time up top, and they will try to kill Soxa. It's not an easy one to get. He's got some help from 33.
See, like, we're definitely living in a simulation, no doubt about it. The Tundra, same thing happened in all three games so far. Tundra out farming OG. OG lacking in a damage department. Look at him. Soxa finding another one.
Yeah, Taiga, one shot from Dead. The Spirit Vessel will take him out. Soxa trying to survive, running back, has the Guardian Greaves help coming in from 33, as well as the Seeds of Serenity down, but the right clicks in from Misha, and some damage from BZM is all they need to get the kill there on to the Tiny, but it ends up being a trade. They find Nine, they'll pull him in with the Vortex, and Nine, he won't be able to run.
That was big, BZM.
But two heroes, they don't have the damage to really blow him up, but they might find Nine again. Vortex, Illuminate, and it's not going to be enough to save him as BZM gets another kill on a Nine.
That's a good kill.
Back-to-back deaths.
Two kills in a row, and they also set up some vision. Two Observer Ward plates, the one in a triangle, one near the big camp, near the tier 2 tower, so they can start to play a bit more aggressive. Global Silence was used this time around, and you see Yoragi immediately joins. He does have that silence. Orchid is coming up to him.
He saw him. So that's on cooldown. 33 TPing right in front of DM, and this is big for OG if they can get it. They get the kill on 33. They'll look over at Skitter with everybody here. They'll clean him up with the Whirling Death. They also take out Snake King. OG even the game up. Now it is really favoring OG. Found Soxa. Have the Orchid. They'll have the kill. They'll get the kill onto Soxa and look for more. So Snake King trying to run, but there really isn't anywhere for him to go, especially with the Arcane Curse and the Last Word on him. They've also got 9. BZM doesn't have a lot of mana to work with. The Illuminate hits him. Spirit Vessel, Blink, Avalanche, and the BKB's been popped by the Coddle. TP out.
First usage of a BKB. Like just two of those together inside the Midnight Pulse, inside the Shard from Dragonite. It's going to be some serious amount of damage if they can execute.
Song, Misha is being chased. He's acting as bait. Yoragi with the song. Do they have a follow-up to go for this? They're actually over on the 33, but they've got the Avalanche as well as the Sunray. They have the silence. It's out of the Tiny Ball, ending out of the high ground, but he's been stunned up again. BZM now needs to run.
He's got to kill the creep.
Bottle.
No
he's
nine.
Sipping up and trying to get back into the fight is DM. He'll come over with the Chakram as well as the Whirling Death. Timber Chain right on top of 33. He's chasing pretty far. Goes up into the air. Tugger comes over with an Avalanche. Ends up into the Fade Bolt. They'll get the kill on a Snake King. Now they look over at Skitter trying to run. The Veil, the Chakram, the kill. The Ball Lightning in from BZM as they continue to extend their lead, but BZM, he'll lose just the Aegis.
Now BZM, he decided to go for a sneaky little play. He saw 9 TPing.
If they just hang on. Dotapus is going to be 64-36.
The Switchblade not allowing him to blink
toss.
Out.
BZM is going to die here before Soxa goes down. Look over to the side. They've cut themselves DM. Can't let it crumble now, but look at the damage onto the Timber. Growing Death, Spirit Vessel, right clicks, Midnight Pulse is in, and the Timber Chain doesn't connect. They get the kill onto the Timber Saw as well.
Gotta be careful, you know. This tiny combo is still always gonna be an issue, even if it's coming out from position 4, position 5 against these heroes. Like, he's tanky. He does have Kai, Assange, and Storm Spirit, but try to toy with him way too much.
They are coming pretty close to each other. Taiga, he's got a blink, so he's looking for the telekinesis. He finds it onto the Tiny. Now they're gonna ball lightning in. They've got the silence onto Soxa. He's not gonna survive this, or will he? Ooh, he finally drops to Yoragi, but there's the song. Will-O-Wisp making this a little bit difficult for Yoragi. They also use the supernova. Misha on the run. Can they continue to chase for it?
Yoragi is still full HP. Does have BKB if necessary. Does not want to pop it just to get rid of that.
Skitter finds the stun on a Taiga. Popping that Manta. BZM trying to help out, but it looks like they're going to lose this Rubik. So Taiga falls. They've got the Vortex. They're going to buy back here on the Tiny. They'll go to the BKB from Yoragi. He doesn't have a song to work with. And now they've got the Global Silence coming out, but they still have a Black Hole available on the side of Tundra. So they'll look over at Yoragi as Misha. He's going to die here to the Illuminate from 9. Bop back on this Rubik. Icarus dive over. Soxa finding the avalanche. It's on Yoragi. They've got the telekinesis. They have the silence from the Orchid. Yoragi still running up out of the high ground. And now these heroes on the side of Tundra. How far do they want to go in? Skitter doesn't have the Elder Dragon form for that much longer. And these heroes are all alive from OG once again.
With more burst damage.
Midnight Pulse down on the ground. Taiga coming over with the telekinesis, but the Will-O-Wisp is going to drag 3. They've got the avalanche as well as the toss. They're going to throw back Taiga, who bought back in the last fight, so he's going to be dead for 75 seconds. Black Hole, it's on a rush with the song, but the Aegis is going to be picked up by BZM. Oh, Will-O-Wisp still pulling them in. After the song is up, do they want to fight this? The song lasts long enough for the TP out from the Naga Siren. They'll look for the rest. They're trying to find DM, but with a Timber Chain, he is far enough away. What can they do? Mid is going to get pushed in with these illusions and start to hit away at the tower. Meanwhile, they've got a big creep wave bottom and illusions doing the same there. Avalanche toss! Oh, BZM! God! That's not as planned.
That was quick. That's some quick reaction there from Tundra. He tried to go for sneaky play, cut the creep wave, but it didn't happen. Both bottom is pushed in. Tier 3 tower almost dead, but
yeah.
Tundra's doing the same thing on top.
They also had mid pushing in. That's a big issue, too. You're losing multiple parts of your base.
They need a creep wave, though.
Yeah, they do. This is another creep wave coming in, so they've got a creep wave just in time. As the tower bottom, it has 17 health.
Something about Dragonite with Manta style is satisfying to watch. I don't Maybe I'm just one of those enjoyers that love to see the world burn.
No, I agree with that. Any smokes or vision that's coming over from OG, but it's just not in time. So they will pick up these items. And Ags, it's on this Phoenix, and now they've got the Will is down, they've got the speed for
good
a second, Skitter
step.
Coming over, and now they've got the 4-step back with the Midnight Pulse, but the Ball Lightning as well as the Vortex is going to be on 2 of these heroes. 33 trying to run away, and it gets out. KB from DM, Chakram, 2 of them thrown at 33, but he still survives. They'll go to the song. They've got a Hex, it's on a Taiga. And Icarus Dive, finding the Rubik, Malifus, they've got
BKB.
These Eidolons. BKB, TP, ooh, Black Hole to stop it. He knew he was gonna be stunned up again, but he uses the Black Hole and goes for a Rubik. Yoragi's still sitting there in the front line. Dagon, Blinding Light, they've got the Hex, it's on a Skitter, but again, he's got that Aegis to work with for another minute and a half. Going into the mirror image with the BKBB pop by Taiga. The Midnight Pulse is down. They've got the Will-O-Wisp. They'll have the Hex. They have the control. It's on to Yoragi. Can they get into the base, though, to get this kill? They're trying to clean up the Will Wisp. Skitter's going to blink right on top of him with that overwhelming blink. They've got the break. It's onto the Dragon Knight still. That Lotus Orb is going to reflect the ensnare. Vortex onto two of these heroes. It's onto 33 as well. Snake King, Snake King getting low. He's going to be killed off by Taiga immediately. They get the kill on the DM. The look over. They've got the token. It's onto the Enigma. 33 up in the air. There's a gem on the deck. Meanwhile, they finally took out that bottom tier 3, and it looks like these rocks are in trouble for the side of Tundra. They need to be careful about how much they
fight. Taiga does have a blink.
Taiga blinking, avoiding that avalanche, and the rest of the team is starting to follow this one up. They're coming over from the side of OG. The bottom racks looking like they might break here for the side of Tundra if they're not too careful on this fight. So, Creeps still pushing in. The Will Wisp is going to be on to two. DM,
they're going to lose the Baron's
bottom. With some help from Yoragi, they've got the sleep out of these heroes once again. Sokka trying to leave with the Lotus Orb. They've got the Hex. It's going to be on to DM, but now they go to the song from Yoragi. So, they've got a fireball down. They're looking over at nine. They've got the Chakram right on top of him. When he wakes up from this slumber, ball landing over with the BKBB pop by nine. They'll go over 33 with the BKBB
on his own. 33.
He's trying to throw a black hole, but he doesn't really find the opportunity to do so. Taiga over to the side. He doesn't want to give it up. The ball landing's going to come over. They're trying to get the kill here. They'll find DM right on top of 33. They get the kill of the Enigma, but the damage coming in from Taiga will get the Rubik. Can they? Oh, the Ogre Seal Totem on the right on top of him. Sokka gets the kill on a Rubik. They find themselves nine. They've got the dagger, but it's not going to be enough damage. Skitter comes in with the fireball. They've got themselves the Global Silence. And is that going to keep your Yoragi alive? DM comes in.
Everyone's
double
so chakra. Low.
They've got the Hex. It's onto the DK. He's still in that Elder Dragon form. Ball lighting over to the Tiny. They've got the Avalanche. It hits
another
Yoragi as well as BZM. They've got the stun. It's coming through to Yoragi. They get the kill to BZM.
Watch Skeeter's coming in.
Down goes Yoragi. Misha under the fireball. He's going to fall too. 4 years down on the side of OG as DM finally TP's out. But this is not a big fight for OG like they needed.
Man, this is a 2 minute fight right there. What the hell is happening?
They need to clean up these creeps bottom. They lost that set of racks.
If need be, Elder Dragon form. Oh, look at that cute dragon.
Uh-oh. Look at him die.
That's...
get zapped.
That's not great. That was some National Geographic stuff right there. As, well, now they're going to go after Yoragi. They've got the Will Wisp. They have the control. They've got the Dragon Tails, and they're going to get another kill to Yoragi just like that.
Nobody's here. BZM going in with the DM. Timbersaw. They'll take out 33, so the Enigma's gone. Has buyback. So does Yoragi, but the BKB BZM's going to TP out of this one. Overwhelming blink towards DM.
Catch him.
Four staff forward, Dragon Tail lands onto the Timbersaw. Can he get out of this one? Avalanche to follow it up. The Stunlock is there. They've got the dagger. Do they have the control with the toss up into the air? They do. They'll take out DM.
He fought back in the previous fight, so he's going to be gone for 2 minutes. The buyback from Naga. Tundra slowly opening things up. A 20k gold lead, but this is the entrance to, like, one more fight is all it takes for them to win the game. And you see this Dragonite, like, being just super annoying. Does have a buyback available. Speaking of unkillable, this Dragonite, he's inside and outside of the base at the same time.
Schrodinger's Dragonite.
Look at that range. Level 28 DK.
Stealing the Breathe Fire, Telekinesis, and now look at that with the Mjolnir armor. They've got the Hex, Yoragi going in with the BKB, the ball landing, they've got themselves the Vortex, it's going to be on a 2, can they get the control on a Skitter? It's going to be rough. He also has himself the Aegis, so even if they get this first kill, how do they follow it up with another one? The Aegis out of his hand, Sox in some trouble, the Avalanche toss, they get the cone to BZM, he does have buyback, the song not in time, so Yoragi, just the song being a little bit too
a
late
black
and
hole
not
on
getting
Timber.
Them up. They've got the black hole, it's on a DM, they'll lose DM, they have buyback, but it just, it's gonna be rough to
they
hold.
They need to use the buybacks.
Yeah, buybacks come out by both these heroes, they'll look to get the kill
Supernova
on.
To save him.
He got the save, he put the Supernova, now they'll go over Yoragi, the Sunray burning him away, he's got the Hex on him, and he's dead.
That's
two
game,
minutes,
he has no buy.
No buyback. Icarus dive over, the Andis is going to be popped. They'll go to the overwhelming blink. They'll get the kill on the Taiga. They finish off another one. As it's four heroes that have died, but three of these buybacks have been used by OG. They do not have Nagasire. They're going to have themselves Mega Creeps. Vortex on to 2, 33. He's going to have some help here. They've got the Avalanche as well as the Toss. BM in trouble. BCM, he cannot get out and will fall to 33. They'll also find Taiga. They'll get another kill on the Rubik, and they'll call GG. It is the same as it ever was.